Hi guys, welcome to BPrep, where we whiteboard quant questions appeared in previous year papers. Before we start with the question, please take a moment to subscribe to the channel to get updates on latest videos if you are preparing for any of the competitive exams. Let's start. A box contains 6 cricket balls, 5 tennis balls and 4 rubber balls. Okay, so we have a box in which we have cricket balls, 6 tennis balls, 5 and rubber balls, 4. Okay. Of this, some balls are defective. The proportion of defective cricket balls is more than the proportion of defective tennis balls, but less than the proportion of defective rubber balls. Okay, so let's say out of these total balls, this is total number of balls. Out of these total balls, defective count of defective balls are small c, small t and small r. Okay. It is given that the proportion of defective cricket balls. So what is proportion of defective cricket balls? It will be C by 6 or small c by 6 is the proportion of defective cricket balls. Okay. This is more than the proportion of defective tennis balls. This is more than T by 5. Okay. Proportion of defective tennis balls. But less than the proportion of defective rubber balls. But this quantity is less than R by 4. Okay. So this is the order of proportion of defective balls. Moreover, the overall proportion of defective balls is twice the proportion of defective tennis balls. Okay. It is also given that overall proportion of defective balls. So what will be overall proportion of defective balls? It will be R plus C plus T by 10, 15. So this is the proportion of overall defective balls is twice the proportion of defective tennis balls. So this is 2 into T by 5. So what best can be said about the number of defective rubber balls in the box? So we need to find out the best possible value for R. Okay, the number of defective rubber balls. Okay, so if we solve this here, see, this will be 5, 3, 60 and 1T will be subtracted. So we'll have R plus C equals to 5T. So this is the equation that we are getting. And we have one more thing to validate. So we have this one condition and these two conditions. If these two conditions are satisfied, we'll get the answer. Okay. So if we look into this expression, what could be the possible values of R, C and T? Okay. So let's take this. The first possible value can be if T is 1. Okay. So if T is 1, we will have 5. And then R and C, they can be either 2 or 3 or they can be 3 or 2. Okay. So here we are assuming T equals to 1, R equals to 2, C equals to 3. Okay. This is possible. And in the second case, we are assuming again T equals to 1, R can be 3 and C can be 2. Okay, so these two things are possible. Third thing is also possible. So if T is 2, then this value will be 10. Okay, so if T is 2, then RHS will be 10. And if this is 10, here if you see R and C, so total number of R is 4 rubber balls and total number of cricket balls are 6. So they cannot, the defective balls, the small letters denotes the defective balls, they cannot go above the total number of balls. So here in this case, R has to be 4 and small c has to be 6 because they cannot go beyond this. Okay, so this is again 4 plus 6 is equals to 10. Here we are assuming R is 4, C is 6. Okay. So for R and 6, there could not be any other combination because this is the highest number of balls. And if we take 3, this RHS will be 15 and R plus C, maximum value of R plus C can be 10. Okay, because we have those many number of balls. So T cannot have a value of 3. So from this equation, only these 3 possibilities are there. Okay, now let's try to validate these 3 into this equation. Okay, so if we take T equals to 1, okay, then if T is 1, then this expression will be 1 by 5. Okay, if it is 1 by 5, that means 20%. Okay, so we are trying to validate this first expression here. So this is 20%. Okay, C is 3, so 3 by 6 will be 50%. Okay, this is greater than 50%, so it is holding the condition. And R equals to 2, so 2 by 4 is again 50%. Now see here, this condition is not meeting. Okay, this should have been greater than 50%, but it is not matching. Okay, so first option is not possible. This combination is not possible. Okay, now if we validate the second set that we have got here, again T equals to 1, so 1 by 5 is 20%. Okay, C is 2, so 2 by 6 is approximately 33%. Okay, so this is greater than this condition is getting satisfied, and R is 3. So 3 by 4 will be 75%. Okay, so this set is satisfying both the condition, this condition as well as this condition. So this could be a possible answer, this set. Okay, now let's validate the last set. Now in this case, T is 2. So 2 by 5 will be 40%. Okay, and C is 6. 6 by 6 will be 100%. Okay, this is still valid. Now R is 4, so 4 by 4 will be again 100% here. But again, this condition is not satisfying because the proportion of defective rubber balls should be greater than defective proportion of defective cricket balls. So this is not greater than this 100%, and 100% are equal. But this should have been greater than 100%. So this set is again not satisfying this condition. So this set is also not possible. So only possible set is this. And from this set, we see the value of R can be 3. So the correct option is defective number of rubber balls should be exactly 3. It cannot be 2, 4 or any other value. Okay, it should be exactly 3. Thanks for watching this video. If you have any doubts or questions, please post in comments. And guys, please do subscribe to the channel by clicking the subscribe button below to get updates on latest videos. Thank you.